Welcome back to another Google AdMob tutorial. This is the second part of our two-part app open ad series. In this video, we'll focus on implementation best practices and important policy reminders. We will also address more frequently asked questions that developers have had about app open ads. Meanwhile, feel free to check out part one of this series for an overview about app open ads. Now, let's dive in. Let's begin with the best practices. First, how can you find out if app open ads are a good fit for your app? A great way to do that is by running a Firebase AB test on app open ads. You can divide your traffic into two groups, one that sees the app open ads and one that does not. From there, measure and compare the performance between the two groups on key user metrics such as retention and app rating. This allows you to decide if the new app placement is suitable for your app. After all, different ads perform better in different apps, app categories, or regions. For more information on how to successfully set up a Firebase A/B test, you can check out our Firebase video series linked in the description box below. Next, how can you increase your ads show rate on your app? We recommend prefetching app open ads for future ad placements. This helps to increase the number of ads displayed within your app by ensuring a continuous loop of app open ads whenever users open or switch back to your app. Lastly, how can you control the frequency capping of app open ads? You can use the AdMob dashboard to review your app's performance and adjust the app open ad frequency capping accordingly. You can do so by enabling the frequency capping feature to control the number of impressions per user in a day. Now that we've covered the implementation best practices, let's run through some important policy reminders to help you stay compliant. First, your app open units should only appear when the user opens or switches back to your app. Second, you should only place the app open ads on your app's loading screen. Please note that if you have two types of loading experiences, app open and app switch, you may have to implement app open ads differently for each loading experience. In addition, if you do not have a loading screen as part of your app open or app switch experience, you may show an app open ad immediately upon app open or switch. Third, make sure that the app open ads are not placed on top of other ads. For instance, the app open ad should not be placed on top of other content that includes a banner ad. And finally, no ads should be implemented right before or after app open ads. Now, let's move on to some additional common questions developers have had to help you have a smooth implementation. Question 1. Is it possible to serve app open ads on a loading screen that already displays banner ads? It depends. If the banner ad is displayed at the top of the loading screen, app open ads cannot be served on the same screen. This is because the banner ad may fall within the transparent background of the app open ad, which would then lead to a policy violation. If the banner ad is displayed at the bottom of the loading screen, app open ads can be served on the same screen. However, this is highly discouraged as the banner ad may still fall within the transparent background of the app open ad. It's not a good user experience and could trigger a policy violation. Question 2. Will mediation be supported for app open ads? Yes, as of now, we are supporting mediation on app open ads with limited networks. Please note that we intend to extend this to more networks in the future. Question 3. How can I ensure that app open ads are cached properly? Cached requests in the app open beta will time out after 4 hours. Ads rendered more than 4 hours after request time will no longer be valid and may not earn revenue. So, before serving the ad, you should check the cache time. If it is more than 4 hours, you should then load another ad before serving. And that concludes the second part of our App Open Ads two-part series. Once again, thank you for watching this Google AdMob tutorial, and we hope you find it useful. Before you jump off, please check out the description box below for more resources to help you get started with App Open Ads. And one last thing, be sure to subscribe to the Google AdMob channel for more best practices and tips on how you can grow your app further. See you next time!